At MA Performance, we realize that installing things on your own car can be tricky and frustrating. We put together this video to help you through the installation of your new Evo 10 fuel injectors. Without further delay, let's go. Here's a list of tools required: socket wrench, 10mm socket, 12mm socket, socket extension, torque wrench, pliers, flathead screwdriver, small screwdriver or pick, seal glide or vaseline, and penetrating oil. The first step is to relieve fuel pressure from the system. Open the in-car fuse panel located above the hood's release lever, below the steering wheel. Locate the connector with a single blue wire and unplug the connector. The fuel pump is circled here in red. Start the car. It will stall out. Crank the car for a few seconds to be sure there is no pressure left in the fuel system. Next is removing the fuel rail. Start by removing the upper intercooler piping and disconnecting the top half of the wiring harness. Tuck the harness out of the way, like shown. Disconnect the PCV hose from the valve cover. Remove the fuel pressure regulator hose from the return hard line, circled here in yellow, and remove the vacuum line from the fuel pressure regulator, circled here in red. Unbolt the fuel return hard line at the 5 points circled. Use a 10mm socket and wrench to remove the 4 screws and 1 nut. Here are some more detailed views. Move the fuel return hardline out of the way. Release the fuel rail feed line by popping the red clip to the right using a flathead screwdriver. Do not remove the clip from the coupling. Remove the 2 fuel rail bolts using a 12mm socket and wrench. Pull the fuel rail out. You want to pull the injector straight out of the intake manifold. Be sure not to drop those 2 blastic fuel rail spacers circled here. Onto replacing the fuel injectors. There is still gasoline in the fuel rail. You can let it slowly drip out of the feed line or remove one injector carefully and then the fuel will pour out. First, remove the retaining clip from each injector by prying them gently with a screwdriver. You don't want to bend the clips. Pull each injector out of the fuel rail. It may help to use some penetrating oil in the O-ring area. If the O-ring stays in the fuel rail when the injector is removed, be sure to remove it with a small screwdriver or pick. Be sure not to scratch the fuel rail. Apply seal glide or vaseline to the top O-ring of each injector. Insert the injector into the rail with a light twisting motion. The electrical connector will be in the opposite side of the rail mounting tabs, as shown. Please note to be careful not to tear or damage the O-rings. Place the retaining clips back onto the injectors. Be sure that the clip is fully seated and the fuel rail is locked to the injector. Finally, reinstalling the new fuel rail. This is done in reverse order of the fuel rail removal, with a few important notes. Again, use seal glide or vaseline to lubricate the injector lower O-rings. Then align the injectors with the ports in the intake manifold and press the injectors and rail into place. Make sure the plastic fuel rail spacers are also in place. Reconnect the fuel inlet line to the fuel rail and lock the connector plate. Install the 2 fuel rail bolts and tighten to 107 inch pounds. Apply seal glide or vaseline to the fuel rail inlet nipple before installing the fuel line connector. Reattach the fuel return hard line and tighten fasteners to specified torque, 4 screws, 1 nut, red to 49 inch pounds, green to 75 inch pounds, and orange to 98 inch pounds. Reconnect the upper half of the wiring harness to all connectors. If using plug and play adapters for the injectors, connect them in line with the stock injector connectors, as shown here. If you are using solder-in connectors, you will need to cut off the stock connectors and solder the new connectors in their place. We did not show that. Reconnect the fuel pressure regulator return hose, fuel pressure regulator vacuum line, and PCV hose. Reinstall your upper intercooler pipe and you're done under the hood. Reconnect the fuel pump connector on the inside fuse panel and the install is complete. Installation of new injectors requires a retune. Do not try to start the car or drive on new injectors if the car has not been tuned for them. Once you have the proper tune installed, start the car and check for leaks. We hope this was helpful. Stay tuned for more tech tips and install guides in the near future, or check out the maperformance.com/tech site for many more. And as always, subscribe for more awesome updates from us at MA Performance.